Hi there, and thanks for joining us here on the web. I'm Erin Fehlau. The campers are in place, and the weather looks great for race weekend, but hot. Before the engine started revving this morning, some of the NASCAR drivers decided to help raise money for the Children's Hospital at Dartmouth. Ray Brewer has more from the Magic Mile in Loudoun.
I really feel like there's just more of a buzz this year, this weekend going into it. The campers got here a little bit earlier than normal. We're seeing bigger crowds.
And while the big race is still days away, for some, the NASCAR experience has already started.
The sound of ice just brings back fond memories.
Alan Rohde and his friends look forward to this weekend all year.
Your neighbors are always great. The showers, well, you know, a couple more would be nice, but they're nice. And the race is always awesome. I like the Saturday races. This year here, we get to go to the pits. So we're excited to go to the pits this year. So it'll be a lot of fun.
And not all the fun has to do with racing.
You know, you get to, hang out with a lot of different folks, and you get to meet a lot of different people. And I think for the most part, it's fun just to get away for just a little while.
The race is also a chance for charities to raise some money. For 11 years, the Governor's Breakfast has benefited Chad. Joey Logano is an ambassador for Chad and David's House.
I hold a special place in my heart for sure. To go up there and visit the kids and see how they're doing. I got to do that a few years ago and was able to find time to do it again this time. Just to put a smile on one kid's face makes it worth it.
This will mark the eighth and final year that Governor John Lynch, who is not running for re-election, has hosted the breakfast. He, like Logano, is glad to donate his time for a good cause.
Talking to some of the Chad patients, they tell me that Chad for them is like a second family, and that's the way they're treated. And obviously the care that's offered to them is just outstanding.
And we will have more on race weekend starting tonight in our live team coverage. Well, a bear is missing from the Lakes region, a giant wooden bear, that is. This 5-foot-tall carving weighs around 300 pounds, was carved by a local woman known as the Tree Lady. But last night, it was stolen from the yard of a store on Route 104 in New Hampton. There is a reward for information leading to an arrest. If you see the bear, call New Hampton police. Well, this morning, the explosive boom of cannon fire could be heard echoing throughout downtown Portsmouth. It is all a salute for two tall ships being welcomed into Portsmouth Harbor for the start of Sail Portsmouth 2012. WMUR's Mike Garrity joins us with a look at the ships that are headlining the event this weekend.
Well, the tall ships certainly have landed. We're standing on the state fishing pier just across from Prescott Park in Portsmouth, where the tall ships are in this weekend. Take a look behind me. You see the Pride of Baltimore II. Now, this was a Baltimore Clipper. This was a ship designed to outrun British warships back in the 1700s. This has some angled masts, and back in the day, this was the Ferrari of vessels at sea. The other ship that is visiting Portsmouth Harbor this year for Sail Portsmouth 2012 is called the Providence. It's a schooner that was actually the original ship that headed up America's Navy back prior to the Revolutionary War. This was the ship that John Paul Jones was originally the captain of. It was credited with taking or sinking some 40 British warships back in the day, as they say. These ships are both open to the public for tours this weekend on Saturday and Sunday from 10 until 5:30 at night. Admission is $9 for adults. Children under 12 get in free. And we will have much more on this story coming up tonight, brand new between 5 and 6:30. We will see you then. For now, in Portsmouth, Mike Garrity, WMUR News 9.
Ever wonder what happens behind the scenes here at News 9? Well, now is your chance to find out. Our website is featuring a slideshow of what happens on News 9 Daybreak when the cameras aren't rolling. You can check out the pictures at WMUR.com. Well, starting tonight at 5, when it gets hot outside, you turn on the fans. But how much do they actually help? Researchers have a surprising answer. And we've got live team coverage, as I mentioned, as race weekend starts in Loudoun. Look at the fans and the racers preparing for that race around the track. That does it for us. Thanks for joining us and have a great weekend.